Yo, what's going on, everybody? It is your boy Steady180, and look, apologies, I did want to actually bring you a live stream today. Unfortunately, I really couldn't. There was just some latency issues. For some reason, my bit rates kept getting lower and my frames per second just weren't high enough, and it kept kind of cutting in and out, so apologies. So what I've actually had to do was actually just kind of open them up and record it with a little bit of commentary. So yeah, what you're about to see was actually just me kind of doing a little pack opening. So apologies, I am going to try and fix it in the future because I do want to bring you some live streams, obviously, for some brand new pack openings. But yeah, unfortunately, I couldn't do it today. So what you're about to see is just actually the recorded version with me talking over the top. But stay on the lookout because you're going to see something pretty cool. So hope you enjoy. All right, first pack underway. And man, we're kind of really not getting anything good from the first pack. I mean, it's just the first one nonetheless, so it doesn't really make much of a difference because the amount of packs that we're going to be opening up today is just going to be absolutely crazy. So I'm assuming that we have to be at least pulling something decent. I mean, people I've seen have actually been pulling these Pink Diamond Blake Griffins, and I've just gone back-to-back Goran Dragic. So I'm actually pretty hyped. Man, if I see that Pink Diamond glow, I'm just going to absolutely lose it because it will be my actual first legit Pink Diamond pull for brand new 2K19, and what a way to go. I mean, if I do not get it today, if it ends up being something like a Magic Johnson or even like the Michael Jordan one, if they do drop him, it would just make everything so much sweeter. But hopefully we can pull him today because I do not want to be spending so much money trying to get this card. That's why we're just actually ripping through these packs, man. Like, fingers crossed that we can, because I'm just waiting to see that first 20th anniversary box is done, when they actually do have the chance to get that Galaxy Opal Chris Paul. They've got three more to drop. So you've got to pull six Pink Diamonds in order to get them. And then there's kind of 18 in total. So the ones that they've released are for the first one, I should say. We've also got the Giannis Antetokounmpo, Michael Jordan, and the Magic Johnson. Everyone thought it was going to be Magic Johnson today because of his jersey number being 32, but yeah, it didn't end up being him. And then everyone kind of got trolled on Twitter because everyone was saying it's Magic Johnson, Magic Johnson, Magic Johnson. And then Ronnie tweeted out and he's like, not the number 32 who you're thinking of. So it was a bit of a bummer, but I mean, nonetheless, it's like you still have a chance to pull a Pink Diamond. So I guess I don't know why everyone's being a little bit kind of like antsy regarding it, because you know that they are going to be bringing him out later. So you may as well just wait for it. It's not like you're going to miss out on anything, but man, we're pretty much just flying through this first box. And there we go. There's our first throwback elite. Darius Miles of the Clippers, I should say. I think he's only going for around 2,000 MT in the auction house. So even if I didn't pick him up, I could always buy him quite cheap as well. But I kind of don't want to be spending MT in the auction house just because I'm mainly saving it to finish my heat check collection and everything. And that's the main reason why. So if we can keep pulling kind of good cards, maybe I can make a little bit more coin off them. But yeah, let's get straight into the second box. Okay, time for box number two. And we didn't really get anything decent from that one. The first one, we only really got the Ruby Darius Miles, who actually got added to the brand new collection as part of the throwback sets. But man, we just need to keep pulling actual decent cards, as I'm just speaking about the man himself. We pull him again. But man, 2K, you need to show me that beautiful Pink Diamond glow. As we do pull kind of a double duo there, I mean, a Sapphire and an Emerald. Pretty good if you're first starting out, but man, considering the fact that pretty much my whole team is now either, it's pretty much Pink Diamond team. I'm just needing that extra fire. I'm needing to get that brand new Pink Diamond Manu Ginobili, as well as this Pink Diamond Blake Griffin, because I think his playstyle is going to fit in quite well to my lineup. I mean, he does come with a 92 open shot 3, which is pretty crazy, because if you add a diamond shoe to him, that can actually be boosted to a 97. And imagine that. You're running down the court, you've got Blake Griffin open on the wing, you're thinking, nah, Blake Griffin can't shoot, and then all of a sudden you're splashing with a 97. I mean, his open shot 3 ball would be better than Stephen Curry. Let's just put that into perspective, right? It would be a lot better. Yo, we actually did it. We can see that Pink Diamond glow, man. I am so hyped right now. And I know that there is no way we can get trolled because we pulled Pink Diamond Blake Griffin, man. We're going to flip this right now and take a look at this beautiful bad boy. The Los Angeles Clippers, power forward Blake Griffin, number 32. Man, that feels so good to see that Pink Diamond glow. Oh, that's right. That's right. Let's rip it in. Let's rip it in. Oh. You know what, on the actual second box as well, how sweet is that, man? That is just exactly what we are after. And now that's just made everything so much better, man. We saw that glow and I could just feel that enthusiasm. Imagine if we actually pull him again. That would be pretty dope, man. Going like a duplicate Blake Griffin in one box. I saw Carlos' story. I think he managed to pull about 3 diamond Klay Thompsons from that moment. If we, it's just, that's what we need. As we pull an Ami, man, we pull an Ami. This is crazy. This could be the brand new DeAndre Jordan. It could be. We could go multiple, or is it a coach? No, it's got to be a player because it's shaking. Is it going to be the Clippers? No, it's going to be the Mavericks. Pelicans, man, we just got Anthony Davis. He was the actual last Ami who I needed to buy to finish the NBA collection. So, now I'll still take it. I mean, he will still sell for something in the auction house, but it still does not compare to actually pulling that pink diamond glow, man. That Blake Griffin just made everything so much more better. And man, we do not have to spend MT now in the auction house to get him. And that's probably got to be the sweetest thing. Probably saved myself close to around 250,000 MT. Your boy did it. Your boy did it in box number 2 as well. Box number 2, man. Box number 2, and we pulled him. That's crazy. The only other card who I would actually be pretty keen to pull is that diamond Oscar Robertson. I mean, he's still selling for plus 100,000. And if it's going to be anything similar to like what happened in the... All right. Okay. I see what you're doing, TK, man. You're trying to convince me to keep going. You're trying to convince me, and it's working. It is working, as we do pull the center for the Los Angeles Clippers. It does come out as DeAndre Jordan, the nice throwback elite there. Man, we pretty much, all we need now to do is just pull that diamond Oscar Robertson. And then we finished all the throwback elites. But look at that, man. We've just added another Ami to the actual collection. It is a brand new card. As we, man, we just pulled double rubies. Are you kidding? Are they both players? That's crazy, man. Kristaps and Paul George. Probably 2 of the most expensive ruby cards. We'll be taking a look at this brand new Blake Griffin card because he's just an absolute machine. Look at that. He is our 3rd pink diamond from the 20th anniversary series 1. His card animation is kind of a bit dopey, just... But man, if we take a look at his stats, it speaks for itself, right? 99 and 99. Come on, man. 6'10" power forward. We take a look at his attributes, 97, 96. He does have some pretty good post stats as well. 97 draw foul. But the main thing I was talking about before is this one right here, a 92 open shot 3. That's crazy. 85 free throw. 99 dunks. I mean, I don't know why I'm surprised there, but a 99 standing, 99 driving, 99 contact. Man, this is just insane. 90 shot contest. He doesn't really have the best blocking tendencies. His rebounding's pretty nice, but 90 speed, man. 90 speed. 89 acceleration. Man, this card's looking pretty good. What are his tendencies like? His dunking stats have to be off the chart. 100 across all 4. Driving flashy, alley-oop and putback. Man, this card is just insane. It is insane. Take a look at his badges. 6 Hall of Fame badges, man. Relentless finisher, pick and roller acrobat, posterizer, man. That's the one I'm so hyped for. Lob City finisher and pick and popper. He does come with some pretty nice gold badges as well, like catch and shoot, difficult shots, bruiser and brick wall, and chase down artist. Man, this is going to be looking sweet. You know what we're going to do? We actually also managed to pull some of the brand new throwback elites. The only other one which we didn't actually get, which I'm kind of... I don't understand the reasoning behind them, is why add Oscar Robertson? He plays for the Milwaukee Bucks. You can see his card is going for quite some value in the auction house. I imagine that eventually they will come down to a buy it now option. But we're taking a look around, man. It's just... I don't get it. It's like... I don't get the logic behind it there. But we can actually add this card to our lineup. I am going to get rid of Maurice Lucas, man. I do not like him in my lineup, which means we can actually swap him out. And I'm probably going to get rid of Carmelo Anthony. The only other option that I have was getting rid of Rashad Lewis. But the thing is, it's just, they're pretty much the same. Except the only thing is Carmelo doesn't have as good defensive tendencies. So I am going to get rid of Melo. We're going to pop him at the backup power forward position. I know I do have Andrei Kirilenko. That card I'm definitely not getting rid of. Because if you take a look at his stats, man, he's just all A's on the side. But man, this line is pretty looking. It's looking pretty beast, I should say, man. I'm failing so hard. My brain's just... But man, if we can add that pink diamond Manu Ginobili as well, we can put AI at the starting point guard and then Manu Ginobili at the starting shooting guard, and we're pretty much going to be having pink diamond soon, because maybe we do rip another 20-pack box. I mean, we did pull a pink diamond. I kind of do want to see if we can pull that diamond Oscar Robertson as well. So, do you know what? We are going to do it, because, man, that second box was just insane. It probably will be the last one that I do. I want to save some VC, actually, for kind of the future ones as well. Or maybe they'll release a brand new kind of, like, premium pack. But, man, if we can pull another pink diamond in here, it's just, I'm going to be just absolutely ecstatic. Absolutely ecstatic. I'd probably do a little dance. I mean, maybe I'll floss. I don't really know. Kind of like a Fortnite thing, but... Oh, it's just such a relief when you get the card that you're after. I mean, it just makes everything worthwhile. The fact that, yes, I have spent so much money on this game, to actually be rewarded with something pretty decent. Ronnie, all the 2K developers, thank you so much for blessing me. But it'd kind of be cool if you can bless me again. I mean, I'd love it. I'd love it right now. I don't want none of those rubies, man. At least it's not Karl Anthony Towns. And please don't start giving me Karl Anthony Towns right now. But, man, I've seen so many other YouTubers pull this pink diamond Blake Griffin today. Some of them are like Killzamoy. Man, if you're not following them, make sure you go do. The other ones include Carlos Story, I think, ended up buying him. And then Shake and Bake, probably he'll probably end up buying him as well. So, man, just all these people who are actually playing 2K19 are actually pulling this card. And it's pretty dope to see. I mean, the fact that you guys who are fans, you know, subscribing and everything, do want to be seeing us try and pull them. And this is exactly why I'm going to be dropping some money on these games, because I know you guys do enjoy it. I kind of enjoy it as well, man, because I just want to actually do finish the collection. I want this channel to keep growing, man, and I do love bringing you guys some pretty good content. As it seems to me, like, we are now only pulling rubies. I mean, the fact that it's Paul George, I'm not complaining, but I do want to see that beautiful pink diamond glow again, as we do get a ruby in the exact same spot. Maybe it's a little sign. Are we going to go back-to-back rubies in the same spot? No, we don't, but we're now getting a sapphire. That kind of like a corner left seems to be the one place that we are getting pretty well in. As you see what I'm talking about? We do get another Ami. It's going to be a duplicate DeAndre Jordan. Milwaukee Bucks. We pulled Giannis Antetokounmpo. All right, I'll take that. I mean, any Amethyst do sell for a little bit of MT. I think it might only be about 20 to 30K, but I mean... What are you going to do? You're going to complain? You're going to complain about pulling some Amis, man? Nah, no way. No way. You can never complain about pulling the Ami. If we can pull that pink diamond, though, that's what I want to see. That's what I want to see. I can't complain. I mean, I've kind of brought my Pat God experience again. We did pull him, and yeah, that can never be taken away, man. I do consider myself a Pat God. I've been pretty really fortunate with the amount of cards that I've been pulling. I think in the last one, when I did the last live stream, man, I ended up pulling like 8 Andre Iguodalas, man, and they just sold for a ton. That boosted my MT up like total. But last pack, this is a coach. I know it because it's not shaking, as you can see. So we're going to flip him, and it is a Mike D'Antoni. I have pulled him already, so we'll see what he sells in the auction house. But do you know what? To end this video off with a lovely little surprise for you guys, we are going to go over here. And we're going to go into our rewards, and I'm just going to show you maybe a little kind of sneak peek of who we're going to be pulling. John Stockton, Dikembe, and Tim Duncan. Probably not going to get the Tim Duncan now that they've just dropped the pink diamond Blake Griffin. The only other card who I'm thinking of getting is probably this Dikembe Mutombo, just to kind of bolster my center position. I'll probably get Tim Duncan last. So yeah, make sure you keep a lookout. I'll probably bring this in another video for you guys, but today, man, glorious day. So yeah, there you go, guys. Look, apologies for not being able to do the live stream for some reason. I think my bit rate was lowered, so I'm gonna have to try and figure that out. But as you saw, man, in the recorded one, we did pull that pink diamond Blake Griffin, and I'm absolutely hyped. So you need to smash that like button down below. You also need to subscribe if new, because I definitely want to be bringing you so much more content in the future, and I need you to subscribe so I can bring that to you guys. As always, thank you so much, and I will catch you all in the next video. See ya.